Business intelligence data analytics is relatively new to healthcare. I think we're very good as a profession in digging through the data and trying to understand evidence-based practice, evidence-based medicine with regard to our patient population. Although I'm not so sure that that translates to data that the pharmacy department or other departments produce. I think a big hurdle that we're working to overcome, and a lot of institutions and talking with them have to overcome as well, is the trust in the data. And so with a lot of disparate systems, with many data streams coming in, I think we're having a tough time really collecting and sorting and structuring the data that we have coming in and then presenting it back out in a transparent way that allows us to make inferences into that data. And without that transparency, without the structure, I think that's led to some instances where the trust of the data may not be where it should be. And so I think bringing that to light first and foremost is the most important. How do you build trust? I think how you build trust is, I think, you have to set the vision of where business intelligence and data analytics in your department is going. Once you know where the vision is going, what's the plan and how do you plan to implement that? And I think you need to carry those domain experts, those frontline clinicians and administrators and anyone else that's supporting the data analytics, data service management team, with the methodology to really bring them along. It's really about education. But part of that education is building trust within the data and making sure that those data streams are structured in a way that folks know where the data came from, they know how it's computed, they know how to use it, and they know how to get access to it in a reliable and meaningful way. Also, they have the time to digest. People need time to move along the continuum, the scale of understanding how to better use health analytics, health business analytics, business intelligence, and that appreciation of the data, where it came from, how it was structured, and how it's been communicated along that continuum is important for the frontline domain expert.